Welcome you all. My name is M. Karthik Kumar, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of EC, Erode Singular Engineering College. Today we are going to see video session on layered architecture in computer networks. So we will see first what is mean by layered architecture. So we know that in computer networks there is basic components: sender, receiver and a communication medium. In this, we have to send the data to the receiver by some process in between them. So we are using so many processes to secure our data to reach the destination from the source. So single person, for example, the single person cannot do all the work simultaneously. So we are dividing those processes into some sub layers. So we are going for this topic, layered architecture. For example, we are sending a courier. So what will we do for the courier in previously? So first we have to take the paper and then write the letter. For example, we are sending a letter from sender, from myself to some other person. He is in some remote area. So I have first initially write the letter, then cover it in the envelope, then I will post in the post box or some other courier man. Then he will take the letter to the courier office, then transport to some other area by through some buses or some other transport mode. Then the letter will be delivered to that destination courier address. So in the courier office, they will deliver to the exact person in the final. So this is the exact courier steps. So likewise, in network, some data from the source to destination have to reach. Then we have to take the data, then process the data to some other destination which we want to send. Then we have to secure the data also. In this way, we are going to separate those layers. So that is we are seeing in this topic, layered architecture. So for this topic, for this layered architecture, in later 1970s, International Standard Organization established a system called Open System Interconnection Mode, OSI layers. In this layer, it is consist of 7 layers. So using those 7 layers, we are sending a data from source to the destination. In this layer, this OSI model mainly to facilitate communication between different system without requiring changes to the logic of underlying hardware and software. This is based on nowadays the data and the technologies changes day by day. So whenever we are installing the some hardware and software, we don't want to update or we don't want to change that hardware and some components to adapt our system. So in this way we are using this OSI model. So next, what are the layers available in this model? So there are 7 layers in this model. So first layer is physical layer, second layer data link layer, third link network layer, fourth layer transport layer, fifth layer is session layer, sixth presentation layer, and seventh one is application layer. So usually we call as first 3 layers are network supporting layers. The next 3 layers, last 3 layers, layer 5, layer 6 and layer 7 are called as user supporting layers. So in this, first physical layer. So physical layer, it is responsible for all those physical components and electrical properties of the data. Such as if we send 1 byte means it consumes 5 volt like that. So in the way, the physical layer which functions such as physical characteristics of interfaces and medium, representation of which if we send the data from sender to the receiver, then it represents how many bits we are sending like those. Then the line configuration. Line configuration means in computer networks all of us know the line configuration means point to point connection or multi point connection. So one device means point to point. One device to multiple devices means multi-point. So in this way, the line configuration also functioned by physical layer. Next, physical topology. Physical topology is nothing but an arrangement of a system in a